Because it's much more common than any of us think. We were sharing experiences of our own experiences, even of having thoughts about running away or even running away. So I think it's a much more common phenomena than we would normally expect. And the statistics in terms of young people who are not found alive, so runaways who die and who are open to exploitation, the number of times people are running away, so the statistics really speak for themselves. This is some, there's very good evidence now with statistical information, and we have to take note of that as policymakers and lawmakers. Well, millions and millions of children are phoning up in a desperate situation, really needing to speak to somebody and have a friendly voice on the end of the phone to deal with a whole range of different situations and questions and crises that they find themselves in. So I'm really, really glad that we've got the hotlines. I would just like to see them rolled out to even more countries. It's obviously a really, really successful project, and it's a very good use of public money. Well, I'm one of the co-founders of the Child Rights Group here in the European Parliament, so why wouldn't I support it? Okay, I don't just do child rights on Child Rights Day, I do child rights like 24/7, okay? And Missing Children Europe is one of the really brilliant NGOs that we are consistently working with. And we can't do our job unless we are working closely with civil society and activists and campaign organisations. So it's very important to have them here, because they're the experts, and if we're making policy, we're making law, we have to take account of the expert information they're providing. I think the main takeaway is that we have to do better at working together across borders, across different member state barriers. I think, you know, Europe's becoming a place where there are more and more barriers rather than more and more cooperation. And what we have to do is to say that we have to go back really to basic principles. You know, the EU is a union of people. It's also a union of children. And what we have to do is to bring down all those barriers that prevent the best cooperation for the most vulnerable people. Well, I think that young people need to be much more directly involved in the policy making. So we've got a child rights group here in the Parliament, but still we are mostly adults talking about children's rights. And I think we need to have more children in the Parliament, directly organising, speaking at, being present in the meetings that we have where we're thinking about the work that we do. You know, children are experts of their own experiences, and they need to be bringing to us the issues that we have to deal with, and they need to be presenting us with the solutions. So I think that's the next step.